Yesterday we have discussed Newton's first law and some of the examples related to inertia definition. Like Newton's first law is nothing but every body continues to be in its state of rest or in of uniform motion in a straight line unless compelled by some external force to act otherwise. Or we can say one more, in other words, until and unless you apply the external unbalanced force, the body which is at rest only, the body which is moving in uniform motion is in uniform motion only. Then we have defined the inertia, tendency of an object to continue its state of rest or motion. It's called inertia. Inertia is directly proportional to mass. Yesterday, some of you are asking doubt which body will have more inertia. So it depends on the mass. If mass is more is the inertia. And there are different types: inertia of rest, tendency of an object to continue its state of rest, inertia of motion. Tendency of an object to continue its state of motion, inertia of direction, tendency of an object to continue its direction of motion. And these are some of the examples. I will be sharing you that this document. You can go through it for inertia of rest, inertia of motion, inertia of direction. We have already discussed many examples yesterday. Before going to Newton's second law, we have to learn one new term called momentum. Momentum, or it is also called as linear momentum. Linear means the body is traveling in a straight line path. The momentum is nothing but a mass in a motion. Physical words, in words we are speaking. A mass in a motion contains a momentum. Or mathematically speaking, product of mass and velocity is called linear momentum or momentum. Momentum is a vector quantity. That means it has both magnitude as well as direction. It is indicated with P. The P above it, arrow should also be there. P. And momentum direction is same as that of velocity direction. So the body, if it is moving in east direction, its velocity is in east direction, then its momentum will also be in east direction. So that is what, because momentum is a vector, it has both magnitude as well as direction. So formula for momentum is P is equal to m into v, mass into velocity, mv. So SI unit of momentum, kg. Mass unit is kg, velocity unit is meter per second. So kg meter per second, or we can also indicate kg meter second inverse. CGS unit, grams centimeter per second, or gram centimeter second inverse. Let us solve some of the examples based on momentum. If mass is 100 kg, velocity is 10 meter per second, then momentum is, your answer please.
So 1000 kg meter per second.
Yes, very good, very good. And let me take second example. Mass is 0.1 kg, velocity is 10 meter per second. What is the momentum?
Sir, 1 kg meter per second.
Yes, very good. Mass into velocity, that's it. P is equal to 100
Repeat
centimeter per
one, sir.
second. Velocity is 10 meter per second. Mass is equal to momentum by velocity, which is equal to 10 kg. Yes, correct answer.
Sir,
Next problem, m is given as 1000 milligram velocity is given as 10 meter per second, then P is equal to how much? Momentum is how
Sir,
much?
10.
Mayuk, correct answer. Mass is 1000 milligram, that is 1000 into 10 power minus 3 grams. Deepika, wrong. So, which is nothing but 1 gram. 1 gram is nothing but 10 power minus 3 kg. And velocity is 10 meter per second. Then momentum is equal to mass into velocity, that is 10 power minus 3 into 10, which is equal to 10 power minus 2 kg meter per second. If this is the standard form. We have to write it in standard form. Don't write it in decimals. Okay. 0.01, not like that. 10 power minus 2, you have to write. Okay. If you solve seventh problem, mass is given in 1 kg, as given as 1 kg, and velocity.
Sir, 25 kg meter per hour. Meter per
second. You have to convert it into meter per second. Then momentum will be 95, sorry, 1 into 25, that is 25 kg meter per second. Is the answer. Okay. Next, ninth problem, mass is given as 2000 grams, velocity is 270 kmph. Then what is the answer?
Sir, 150 kg meter per second.
Yes, correct. Answer is 150 kg meter per second. Or in gram centimeter per second, can you tell me please? In gram centimeter per second, the answer will be 2000 into 7500. Which is equal to 150 into 10 power 5. 10 power 5, which is again equal to 1.5 into 10 power 7 gram centimeter per second. This is the answer in gram centimeter per second.
Sir, next answer is 10 kg.
Yes, sir, 10 kg.
Yeah, P is given and V is given. So, mass is 10 kg. Mass in grams also I asked. Velocity in centimeter per second also I asked.
Sir, mass in gram will be 10,000 gram.
10 kg.
10 kg is equal to 10 power 4 grams. Yes. Correct. Velocity in centimeter per second. Velocity 10 meter, 10 into 100 centimeter per second. So, 10 into 10, 100, that is 10 power 3 centimeter per second. If you want to if you want to know velocity in kilometer per hour, you have to multiply with 18 by 5. 10 into 18 by 5, which is equal to 36 kilometer per hour.